our transformation is when we are completely in our natural state, as when we were a newborn baby. This here is what we call the altar of light, and this started out life as a massage table. Some people are confused about what we do at the temple, and they will phone up and ask, do you do massage at the temple? We do not offer massage, we offer whole body healing. And the altar here is a combination of mother and father energy. So we start out with a massage table. We remove the therapeutic neck part of it because we're not doing therapeutic massage. Now, the bottom part of the altar is lit in honor of the Father. In the temple, light, the sun, and heat are associated with the masculine. So every man that enters the temple is considered to be the sun son. So if you're a man, the S-U-N makes you the S-O-N. The sun is the sun. And in the Aklavan Native American Church and the Goddess Temple, we refer to the men as the heat, the light, and the sun. And men, of course, outflow with that power and light. And so we light the altar in honor of the masculine principle. And of course, the red veil is to represent the red ray of the root chakra. And then here on the top of the altar, we do extra padding because when you are received into the mother's bosom and you're sitting in the lap of your mother as a little child would, you want it to be really soft, very inviting, very comfortable, very safe. So there's extra feather padding here, and then this particular altar is covered with the color green, which is the heart chakra. And so this is the altar of light, and the word altar, A-L-T-A-R, refers to a place that is consecrated, that means dedicated with sacred intent, to alter, to change whatever is upon the altar to a more divine state. So when a person lays on the altar of light for their anointing, their healing, and their guidance, they are saying, yes, take me to my divinity. Take me to the part of myself that is sacred and very close to the mother and father. In every transformation chamber, you'll also see the mirrors. The mirrors are considered part of our temple technology. And in Tantra, it's known that for men, this part of the body, men are very activated by the visual. Women are activated by what we hear. And men are activated very much by what they see. And so we use the full-length mirrors so that if a seeker, an initiate, is a male seeker or initiate, and they want to amplify energy, they can see what's happening with the healer in these mirrors. And again, we have the lights here, the green lights of the heart, and the red light of the root or the first chakra, which is what the temple's really about, activating, amplifying, and integrating the root chakra. And so I wanted to take you this way now and share with you, of course we have towels. Everyone is offered a shower before or after their healing session. For many people, they may be coming from work, they may be on their way to something else. And so, of course, the healing power of water can be part of your time at the temple. I wanted to speak a little bit about the holy anointing. We use at the temple a very special type of oil. This information was brought to the temple by the white tigresses of the Taoist tradition in ancient China. And the white tigress jade dragon tradition is one of the many sacred sexuality, sacred energy teachings that we were sharing with the world at the temple. And the tigress has taught me about the healing power of coconut oil. If you want to anoint your body, use an oil to cultivate your energy and light, we highly recommend, as the only thing you need, raw or cold-pressed coconut oil. And when the oil is processed from the coconut and taken out in a cold state, that is without any heat, then there is a living quality to it which destroys all germs. Raw coconut oil or cold pressed coconut oil is an antimicrobial, antifungal, antibacterial. It kills germs and smells like a cookie. It's the best. So we always have coconut oil in the chamber. And we keep that in a water bath so that when we do the holy anointing, it's kept warm and feels wonderful on your body. This particular palm tree, this came from a palm at the temple here in Phoenix that was growing outside our door. And after the temple was closed, so that we can go through this weaving with our government so that they understand who we are, I picked up this V and I thought, this is a V for victory. I just had one of my dear friends show to me that not only is it the V for the mother, because in these ancient teachings, the downward facing V is the mother, the upward facing triangle is the father. So you have the jewels and the lingam, and that creates an upward triangle. And of course, the mother's triangle is the downward V, which represents the part of the body, the gateway, the yoni, through which all living things enter the physical plane. So here's our V from the palm tree outside the temple in Phoenix, V for victory, and of course the V for the mother's yoni, the gateway to heaven. I'd like to share with you an